What's up, everybody on YouTube? Justin here, Side Hustle Pro. Coming to you with a haul video that I have not done in a while. And I don't know, you know, I like haul videos. They help me sort of look for things to get, things to look out for, things to buy. But some of you may think it's boring. So, you know, if you think it's boring, then go ahead and hit the like button and head out, man. You know, but if you want to, if you're somewhat interested in maybe some things that you can sell on eBay for profit, then go ahead and stick around. All right. So, as you know, or may not know, whether depending on whether or not you follow my channel or not, I've been super busy. Got school, lawn care, college, and some other things coming up. So it's just been a while since I've been able to really hammer this eBay stuff. But the weather's changing. I'm sort of getting the itch, right? And so I went out and I picked some things up. And I just want to share those with you. This isn't a super planned video. I just said to myself, I might as well go home and make a little video of some stuff I picked up before I get it processed and start to get listed. So I don't have all the receipts and all that kind of stuff like that. But I will tell you what I paid for it and about what I'm going to sell it for. All right, so let's just go ahead and start off here. Polo Ralph Lauren. All right, look at that. Just a quarter zip. I always call these things half zips, but for some reason, they're all listed as quarter zips. I learned that a while ago, that when you list it, you can list it as half zip too, but a quarter zip is the option that it gives you in one of the things that you probably go on a list. This is actually pretty good find. It's Polo Ralph Lauren, right? 3X big, okay, 3X big. So that's nice. These that are just the normal sizes, anything that's not like over an XL, I usually sell for about, I want to say like 28 to 30 shipped, right? And I can fit them in a flat rate envelope, and I pay about $5 for it. So I end up making about like 15 off of them, something like that. But they usually sell pretty quick. Now this is a 3X big, so I might try to get 35-ish shipped out of it. I don't know. The prices and stuff fluctuate on this kind of stuff so often, and I haven't listed in so long. And by so long, I mean about like 5 months, 4 or 5 months. And, maybe, let's see. Yeah, say May, June, July, August, about 4 months. Yeah. So I've listed here and there, but I haven't, as far as research goes, I really haven't, scouted anything. I've got some listing done. So anyway, yeah, long story short, the price fluctuates on those, but I should get about that price for at least 30 shipped, I'm gonna say. All right, this is a brand to look out for. They've got some really funky ones. This one is really actually, it's pretty plain, right? It's like a salmon color, pearl snap shirt. Okay, salmon, but it's HBC. Now, when you're out looking for stuff, this is like a vintage thing. I don't even know if they make this anymore. I mean, they might. But all the ones that I've ever found are like vintage like this, but it's HBC ranchwear, all right? And some of them are pretty wild. Like I got a vest. It was a guy jacket, Western look with the tassels all over it. And it was in the women's section at the thrift shop. And I sold it for like $60. And the guy that bought it, he actually sent me a picture of himself with his fiddle, saying how he loved it because he does shows and stuff like that. So that was pretty cool. I don't know how much I'm gonna get for that. I have to do some research. I'm guessing, I mean, I paid $5 for it. I'm guessing I get about $22 for it, something like that, shipped. All right, something else to watch out for, FootJoy, specifically the Dry Joy branch or line of FootJoy. So Dry Joy by FootJoy, right? This is it's like a short sleeve quarter zip golf jacket, right? And now this is interesting because the thrift shop near my house, I don't live in like a community that's like stacked with money. So sometimes when you go to the cities and some of the higher end like neighborhoods, obviously their thrift stores have higher end things. But this was pretty interesting. This isn't like super high, you know, it's not like Gucci or Prada or anything. But I don't know, I found a few FootJoy things in the years that I've been doing this at this specific location, but I found two of these. One was like white and blue, and I sold it. It sold within like 2 days, and that was only like a couple weeks ago. And then I went back and I found this one. So it was sort of odd to find them back to back like that, but I'm glad that I did. These red tags were half off, so these were suits are normally like I think like $9, so I get paid about $5 for these. This is just a it's a navy blue. I don't know if you can see it. The lighting's sort of weird, but it's a navy blue pinstripe. Yeah, the lighting's gonna mess it up. But it's a navy blue pinstripe. It's a full suit. It's got the jacket, got the pants in there, right? And it is it's an older Ralph Lauren. That's just the men's store. So it's a Ralph Lauren University. Oh God, this is such a stupid angle. All right, anyway, it's a Ralph Lauren. It's a Polo University by Ralph Lauren, right? It's a smaller size. I want to say, well, I have no idea because it's such an older line of Ralph Lauren that the tag is completely worn for some reason, just from washing or dry cleaning or whatever. So I'm going to have to measure that by hand and give the measurements. But I'm guessing it's about a 40 or so. It's not big at all. It's pretty small. All right. Got a lot of stuff here. Maybe I shouldn't even go over it all. I'm already tired of talking. I don't know. Anyway, this is a brown, again, half off, I think this was. So this was about $3 or something like that. But it's a brown pinstripe blazer, right? Pinstripe blazer. And it is a Chaps Ralph Lauren. So not a high-end Ralph Lauren. Chaps Ralph Lauren blazer. But it is a, what's the size? There's gotta be, it's a 50R, right? Oh man, so it's a 50R, right? So that's a big suit, okay? And I paid, you know, I think around $3 for it. I don't know how much I'm gonna sell it for. I'm gonna have to get an idea, but I'm guessing, because of the size of it, I'm guessing anywhere between 40 and 50 shipped, I'm hoping. Now some of you may disagree with that and you may say, oh, well that's not enough or whatever, or you know, that's fine. You sell it for whatever you want, but I ain't looking to hold on to it for a long time. I'm looking just to get rid of it. If I can get it for $3 and sell it for $40 shipped, boom, done, right? Get it in, get it out. All right, thrift store had, I don't know if like somebody died or something, but there was a crap ton of Tommy Bahama. It wasn't all the same size, but it was like, I went there one day, and then I went there like a week later, and they had a ton of Tommy Bahama, so I don't know what happened. But this is just a regular Hawaiian shirt, you know, Tommy Bahama right there. It's an extra large. It's got this cool pattern on it. I don't know if you'll be able to see it with the light. You can sort of see it. It's like palm trees and stuff like that, but it's in there like, you see like the leaf right there. It's in there like it's like a raised pattern a little bit, so you can't see it real well, but it is there, and it is wrinkly, so it'll have to be steamed. Found some pretty good stuff. This is stuff that I got yesterday. All right, Southern Tide. Never had a Southern Tide before. I thought I remembered seeing somebody sell it one time. Southern Tide XL, and it's got the little logo there. Looks like these were selling for about 20 shipped, right? 20 to 30 shipped, depending. I paid $5 for it. And yeah, it's not a huge profit, but one of the reasons I got that is any kind of brand that could potentially do well, I just want to sort of try it out, so I'll put it up there sort of high and see what happens. All right, Vineyard Vines, just a pink with blue stripes polo right there. I believe it is cotton, most likely. 60% cotton, 40% polyester. Vineyard Vines, you see that? Yeah, Vineyard Vines. Martha's Vineyard, and so typically they'll have like a logo right here, right, their logo, but this time it's down here at the bottom, right? It's this little whale, so down here at the bottom, right? I'm looking to get 25 shipped out of this, and again, these are just estimated prices, what was going through my mind when I got them. I'm really not quite positive because I have to do some more research on some of them. Here's an interesting shirt. Now, if you can get these for a few bucks, Columbia, is a good thing to get, but not all Columbia, right? So it's like anything you see Columbia that you want to buy. There's a specific kind of Columbia that I like to get, and I'll show you what that is right here. But this is pretty cool. It's a Columbia, and PFG is what you want to get right there. That's what you want to look for, right? And it's performance fishing gear, and it's got all these vents. There's ventilation up under here, there's ventilation back here, and it's got this mesh. And so, I mean, you can stick your whole hand in the back through this vent right here, right? So, with the pattern and everything, it's like swordfish and whatnot. It's pretty cool, and it's a decent size. It's an XL, so I'm looking for maybe 25 or 30 out of that shipped. Nothing fancy, just a Tommy Bahama right there. Tommy Bahama XL shirt. This might not go for hardly anything. It does have the logo on it there, which is nice. So if I can get 22, 23 shipped out of it, that'd be good. Pretty much my standard with shirts, like basic shirts like that, is about, I'll list it for probably like $16.99 plus £1 estimated shipping. So it gives you like a six something. So it ends up being like $22, $23, you know, and that leaves me making, I think, if I remember right, leaves me making about like 12, 13, something like that. So that's okay with me. Here's one, Pendleton XL, 100% wool flannel shirt, right? Honestly, Pendleton, it's hit or miss. So no idea how much I'm gonna list this for. I didn't look it up, I just saw it's Pendleton, 100% wool. Season's getting ready to change. Go try it out. FootJoy again. Here's your FootJoy right there. It's a medium purple striped polyester shirt. Okay, now I've gotten some of these that are like 2Xs. I've sold them for like 30 plus really fast. This does have a third party label of some sort, at least I think it's third party. It's like a Marlin or some crap. But I don't know how much I'm gonna get out of this. I'm hoping about 25, right? It's your basic shirt. Let's see. I got a few more things here. Ralph Lauren XL. Custom fit. Usually the classic fit are decent sellers. I typically Ralph Lauren basic shirts, unless they're like classic fit or custom fit, I won't pick them up. But here it is. Just a regular long sleeve polo. It's like an orange color. It's got a little blue pony on there. That. Let's see. Oh, fashionable or fashionable or however you say it. This is a brand that I've hit or miss with. Okay, if the price is right, it'll sell quick. But this is a 2XL, is why I got it. You know, and it's a big. I wear a 2X, and this thing is too big for me. But it's a nice dress shirt. It's got a nice plaid on there. The thing you gotta watch out for with this brand is they have buttons on the back, right, that snap the collar down, and this one is broken, right, which isn't a huge deal. I'll mention that because it has the extra buttons down here. There was another one like this, but it had a small stain on it, the button was broken, and it didn't have the extra button that it could be fixed with. So when I list it, I'll just say, you know, back button is broken, includes replacement button. All right. Daniel Cremix, I guess is how you say that. I've never really known how to say that, but it's a just a sweater. It's a smaller size. Okay. It's a medium, but it is 100% cashmere. Right? 100% cashmere. So I have to check on the pricing. It doesn't have a lot of pilling. It has some, but you know, cashmere has some pilling anyway. I got a fabric shaver somewhere. It must have fell down. But anyway, I got a fabric shaver, and I'll just go over that. I'll let the kids go over it or something, and get that looking real nice and get that listed. Orvis, always a good brand to look out for. Now this is, I'm not sure about this. Maybe I shouldn't have got this. Y'all, like, I check stuff and then I buy it, I check it like three times at the store, buy it, blah blah blah, and then you always notice something, right? But anyway, here's the deal. Orvis, it's a large, but I don't know if you can see it with the coloring. It's got like a little bit of a sweat stain going on, like around like the rim right here. which isn't, it's not too abnormal, and you can't even really see it, and I can barely see it on here. It's just a slight discoloring. So I'll probably put some, I'm gonna have to put some shout on that, and maybe some felt naphtha or something like that, and then just wash it with my regular clothes that I wear, and see if it comes out. So, all right, another bread and butter item for me here, Brooks Brothers, and it's just a dress shirt, white with red pinstripes, dress shirt. Now, when you buy shirts like this, especially with Brooks Brothers, for some reason, you want to make sure you check the hem or the edge of the cuff here, because for some reason they tend to fray like in the middle here, and it'll be split like all the way around. So you want to make sure that you don't have that. But here's the tag: Brooks Brothers 346, lower end line. 346 isn't a higher end line, but if you notice, it is not iron. I won't pick it up if they're not iron. They don't sell for some reason. I don't know why. Most of them are not iron, but sometimes you find some that aren't, have a hard time selling them. I picked this up. I don't like to sew a lot of pants, but it's a buckle, BKE. It's a super small size, 31, 32. And I don't even know, like, I looked it up, and it's an Adrian. But the only thing, I was just in the store, so I didn't spend a lot of time, or Aiden, I'm sorry, Aiden. But the only thing I could find was actual jeans, like denim. I think these might even be, these are probably women, given how small like the rise is and stuff like that. So I'll have to look them up again, but Buckle's always a good brand to pick up. They're in good shape. Two more things, and that's it, okay? Disney photo mosaic puzzles. I used to, at some point, I'd get the 3D puzzles, count all the pieces, and sell them, and it just got to be too much work, and sometimes the piece count isn't right anyway. So unless they're new, I don't buy them, and a lot of times if they're new, they're still worthless. This, though, is a Disney photo mosaic, right? The photo mosaics are the ones that have, like, it's a picture, but every piece is like a little picture in itself. So I paid $1.99 for that. I haven't checked out eBay or anything, but I scanned it on the FBA seller app, and they were going for like almost $60, right, with like a 24,000 seller ranking. So I'm not doing much on Amazon right now. Until November, I'll probably resub to all my stuff and go get some book sales, but should be a good price there. So $2, hoping to get about 40 out of it. Last thing, and this, I'm sort of excited about this because I've never done it before. It's a golf club, right? It is a, and see, here's my problem with golf clubs. I don't really know anything about golf clubs, but it's a Nike, right? What does it say, 460, 85 or something like that, SQ. I essentially just looked at all the markings, and it's, I got it for $12.99, and it looks like it has not been used. I mean, that's like almost a brand new surface there. It's in great shape. Here's the thing, right? Nike Golf. I think that S right here stands for stiff, maybe. And it's a Sasquatch, whatever this says. Diamana Mitsubishi. Okay. And so it's got there's the end of it there. It's got Nike written around the, Nike written around the bottom there on Nike sign. I paid $13 for this. And at least the solds that I saw on eBay were going for about 60. Now, there were some that were like 80, there were some that were like 45, but it seems like the average seemed to be about $60, $70 shipped, right? So I paid 13 for it, sell it for 60, 70. And my biggest thing with this is I'm thinking, okay, so I got this golf club, right? Now, how am I gonna ship it? Well, what you can do is, you can actually put boxes together, right? As long as they're not like a regional rate A or like prepaid boxes. I'm not prepaid. What am I trying to say? Flat rate. As long as it's not flat rate or something like that, you can take these boxes. These are the shoe boxes from U.S. Post Office, and you can put these things together. Now, I'm not gonna sit here to try and do this and make an idiot out of myself, but essentially, this is what you do. You just put them over each other like this. Stick them in there. And so, you finagle them a little bit. Put them one over the other, and you get a longer box. So, this is my first time trying this. I'm just doing this first time live on video here. So, as you can see, it fits down into there. And if I put maybe about one more box on there and stack them up three high, then I can fit the whole thing in there and ship it like that, right? That's my plan. Now, that may not work. I mean, it will, but there may be a more efficient way to do it. Just haven't thought about it right this second, but that's my idea, is doing that. So that's it. That's my haul. That's some stuff I got. There's two trips altogether in there. So that's what I got last week and this week to try to sell. I'm hoping to get a video up of my sales last week, because I did sell some stuff. I sold something today actually that I've had for like a year, and I didn't make much money off of it, but I was glad to see it gone. And it was like a gravy boat or something, and a canister, and I hate packaging that stuff anyway. I didn't make a lot of money off of it, and it had to ship overseas. So hopefully it doesn't get broken. I put fragile in glass and packed it as best as I could. So sometimes that's all you can do, right? So anyway, like I said, hoping to get my week's report up, and getting back into the swing of things, right? And keep you guys posted. So thanks for watching. If you liked the video, go ahead and hit the thumbs up, leave a comment. Any questions, feel free to ask. And in the meantime, keep on learning and keep on earning.